You ever been jealous of another camera company's colors? I mean, think about it. We hear it all the time, right? Canon has the best color science. Arri Alexa colors are so beautiful. Well, today I'm gonna tell you about a company that makes a tool that lets you have colors from damn near any camera you could think of on your camera. Let's talk about Cinematch. Cinematch is an amazing plugin available for Final Cut Pro, Premiere Pro, and DaVinci Resolve that allows you to transform your camera's colors, as long as your camera is on the very long list of supported cameras, into other cameras' colors. Now, this is great if you have multiple cameras from different companies involved in the same project and you obviously want them to all look the same so everything flows nicely together. Cinematch is great for that. And this is also great if you just happen to not really like the colors coming out of your camera. Just switch them to something else.
So let's say you got yourself a brand new Panasonic GH6 like we're filming on right now, but you're not too fond of Panasonic's colors. Well, we're shooting in Vlog and we can bring it over into Cinematch and maybe change it to Canon colors. How's that look? Or maybe you're a Sony shooter. We're on the Sony FX3 right now. Maybe you don't like Sony skin tones. Well, you could easily switch it over to Arri Alexa? How about red? Nikon? No?
Now, let's say you have your Sony a7S III as your A camera and an a7 III as your B camera, and you're shooting at S-Log 2 on both. Your colors are still gonna look different coming out of each camera, even though you shot S-Log 2 on both cameras, because Sony has updated their color science since the a7 III. So what you could do is use Cinematch to transform that footage to Rec. 709 first, and then you can match all the colors up perfectly. Another thing that's pretty cool is it even works with iPhones and GoPros.
I mean, think about this. You could be out shooting for the day. Let's say you have your GoPro with you, and then you filled in a couple of shots with your iPhone. You can match up the colors pretty damn good. Pretty damn good. GoPro, iPhone. Pretty crazy, right?
Here's a few shots of my beautiful girlfriend Vanessa shot on the Panasonic GH6. Let's mess around with a few colors. Chilly out. She had a jacket with her. She sacrificed it for the shot. And it was a little cold out. Alright, let's match a few shots together from a few different cameras so you can see how it works. On the left side is the Sony FX3 and on the right is the GoPro 10. Okay, so I have Cinematch applied to both clips here in DaVinci Resolve. We'll start with my Sony first on the left side. I'll choose the source profile, which will be the Sony a7S III, S-Log 3, and S-Gamut 3 Cine, and hit apply. And then I'll check where it says apply Rec. 709 transform. Now I'll select my target profile, and I think we'll go with Arri Alexa. I'll make a few exposure adjustments with Cinematch's color tools. The mids are a little too high for my taste. And now I'll do the same thing with the GoPro clip on the right. Select GoPro, Hero 10, and ProTune Flat. Apply Rec. 709 Transform, set my target profile to Arri Alexa, and make some exposure adjustments. Now it doesn't match yet, and that's my fault. I should have been using a color chart or a white card or something, but I didn't. And the GoPro was on auto white balance, and the Sony was manually dialed in, so that's my bad. But that's a good thing. I'm glad that happened because now I could show you how easy it is to match everything up still. First, I'll adjust my temperature and tint a little in Cinematch. Then I'll balance out the exposure a little more. And if you look at the camouflage behind me, the greens and tans match up really good. And so does the orangey yellow color on the other cart. The only thing that isn't really looking right is the sky and maybe my skin tones just a little. But now comes the cool part. In the HSL tab, there's an area that says source and target with a dropper next to it. So I select my source, which is my GoPro clip, and I'll click on the sky. And then my target, meaning what I want my source to look like, is the Sony clip. And I'll click on the sky again, and boom, like magic, it matches up. Then I'll do the same for my skin. and it did a really good job on my skin. It matches really well. The sky still looks slightly off because the 8-bit GoPro gives the sky a gradient, where the Sony's 10-bit just has a much cleaner looking sky, but we could still fine tune it and get it even closer if we want. I'll drop the luminance in the blues a little and then make some small adjustments in the hue, and now we're looking really good. And now I can mix my GoPro footage in with my full frame Sony, and matching colors up will make it all flow together a lot better and not look distracting. I'll leave a link down below if you want to try Cinematch out for yourself. It's the same folks that make Film Convert Nitrate, if you're familiar with that plugin. There's a free trial if you want to test it out, and if you decide that you want to buy Cinematch, make sure you use the code LAPANI at checkout for an extra 10% off. But it gets even better. If you're watching this video between today, April 5th, and April 12th, they're having a special sale, 40% off both Cinematch and Film Convert Nitrate. That's a pretty nice discount. And if you're watching this after April 12th, you could still get 10% off with the discount code LAPANI, which is 10% still pretty sweet. So are you guys. You guys are sweet. Sweethearts. You sweethearts for thumbing up this video. All you new sweethearts out there, make sure you hit that subscribe button. You could hit that bell notification too. That makes me feel pretty good when you guys do that. And you could drop a comment. Let me know what your thoughts are about Cinematch. Thank you, Film Convert, for sponsoring this video. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Yeah!